Baroness Blackstone, on behalf of Baroness Bakewell.
My Lord, I beg leave to ask the question standing in the name of Baroness Bakewell on the order paper.
My Lords, the Law Commission recently published its report on reforming weddings law in England and Wales, and we must consider the 57 recommendations in full. It is important we balance the needs and interests of all groups, religious and non-religious, and consider the implications of changing the law very carefully. I hope to be able to publish our initial response in the first part of next year.
I thank the Minister for his reply, but I must say I'm a little disappointed by it. The Law Commission, to which the noble Lord has referred, took no position on this question, to make a recommendation either one way or the other, because, my Lords, it is a political decision. So what's stopping the government from going ahead and laying an order under the 2013 Act, getting it done now, and stopping once and for all the discrimination against humanists in this area?
Lords, in a nutshell, the government's position is that to lay an order under the 2013 Act solely in favour of humanists would discriminate against other groups, Muslim, Sikh, Hindu, and so forth, in permitting them to have a particular form of marriage not available to other groups. And the government's position is that these, we must go forward together and solve the whole problem. I'll elaborate in a moment what the problem is when you ask your further question.
My Lords, we do need to get a move on here, Nicholas, as one who believes very fervently in Christian marriage, but even more in the institution of marriage, how can it be sensible to allow a wedding to take place in a registry office, but not to allow humanists who have their own ethics to have a proper marriage ceremony? We need to get a move on. We had an almost identical answer last time. Let's have a better one next time.
The Law Commission, in a very detailed and well-argued report, took the view that we should proceed as a country to solve the whole problem across all faiths at the same time and not to favour a particular group. That is the government's position, and we will publish our position shortly.
It will be 10 years next year since I tabled an amendment to the 2013 Same-Sex Marriage Act about humanist marriages, in response to which the government tabled their own amendment, enabling ministers to make this tiny change. It's two words we're talking about, adding "and humanists" to Quakers and Jews. Okay. And all that was done 10 years ago. I have to say to the Minister, it seems highly unlikely that any legislation will pass following the Law Commission report before the next election. Therefore, will the Minister meet with me to discuss how, 10 years on, this tiny adjustment can be made to the law through a ministerial order and to end this discrimination once and for all?
I'm very happy to meet with the noble lady, but I doubt whether I should be able to give her the assurance that she asks for. This is a quite difficult problem. We have to solve it across the board without discrimination, either in favour of or against any faith or faith group or non-faith group. We have to deal with the civil preliminaries for marriage. We have to deal with who is to be authorised. We have to deal with what is the regime for authorisation, and in particular, the problems raised by the APG humanist group itself in relation to the Law Commission's report.
My Lords, why is it, my Lords, that Scotland and Wales have managed to have, in their law, humanist weddings? Why, please, can the noble Lord, the minute, I sound frustrated, it's because I was part of the move, and that with enormous cross-party support, this House agreed an amendment to the Equal Marriage Bill, which would allow humanist weddings, and that has not been implemented by successive Conservative governments. There must be a reason why that is the case, because it is not complicated, it is not discriminatory, it is actually very straightforward indeed. And I might say, if and when my son wants to get married and wants a humanist wedding, he has to go to Scotland or Wales, and that seems to me very unfair indeed.
The Law Commission recommended reform. That's already taken place in other jurisdictions. We're working on exactly how the reform should take place in this country, as fast as we can.
Those of us on this bench, in principle, have no problem at all with humanist weddings, but would not the Minister agree with me that the best way forward is one that's been alluded to already, which is that it could be achieved most easily by following the historical precedents which has been established with Jewish and Quaker weddings, rather than adopting what is the overtly complex recommendations of the Law Commission report?
Government has to consider in detail the Law Commission report, its undoubted strengths, the various points that have been made, not least by humanists, about it, and we will publish our position as soon as we can in the new year.
Are not religious. Every other religion has been treated kindly. LGBTQ marriages can take place. Just the humanists in England are discriminated against. Is the Church of England so upset about humanists that they wouldn't let humanists get married?
My Lord, as far as I know, it's not a matter of the Church of England, this particular problem. The government's view is that we should proceed as a country across the board to solve and update our law of marriage all at the same time.
In Scotland, thank you. In Scotland, where, as has already been mentioned, humanist marriage is legal, there are more humanist marriages than Christian ones, and marriage is more popular than ever. David Cameron supported gay marriage because he believed that marriage is a good thing and everyone should be able to marry. Does this government believe that marriage is a good thing? And if they do, why won't they allow humanists to legally marry?
Hear, hear.
This government strongly supports the institution of marriage, and I think I'm probably boring your lordships by repeating myself, that the government thinks that the whole problem should be solved across the board at the same time and not just with one particular group, the humanists.
My lords, may I declare an interest as an ordained Methodist minister nearing 50 years since he's been ordained, and as someone who enjoys the fellowship of humanist celebrants in funeral services in crematoria across the city. May I therefore declare to the Minister my total bewilderment at the nature of this discussion. It would enrich all of us if people, according to conscience and practice, could marry in the way being asked for in this question. Can the noble Lord understand the predicament that those of us of religious persuasion, and the noble Lord, the prelate, the Bishop of St. Albans has already spoken, and the noble Lord McCormack has spoken from faith positions, it would be an addition to the richness and the value of the ceremonies we produce. Can the government explain why they can't understand this?
Yeah.
With respect, my Lord, I very much hope the government does understand what the problem is. As the government sees it, we should have a regime for marriage in this country in which the civil preliminaries are common to all marriages, which the persons authorised to conduct marriages are authorised under one regime, that we define what belief systems we're going to accept as people capable of authorising marriages, how we're going to exclude extremists and cults and so forth. And these are not straightforward questions. It's a very simple and, if I may say so, not complete answer to say it's easy to do it for the humanists. We want to make sure that, for example, a marriage of a Muslim at home, which might at the moment be a lawful marriage, is now taken forward, and we create a situation in which that does become a lawful marriage, and we have proper officiants and rules and regulations that regulate it all. That is the government's position.
My Lord,
I supported Lady Meacher's amendment
in the Same-Sex Marriage Act of 2013. And the noble Lord the Minister probably feels he's being rather beaten up by members of your Lordship's House from all sides, because we remember what ministers said then, and how the provision that was arranged was deliberately simple to enable this to happen. I am sure that the House would welcome other faiths being drawn into it, but this is very long overdue. Please, can the minister go away and look back at the history of the passage of that act?
So I will go back and look at the history. I am equipped with elderly but serviceable shin pads, and I'm quite used to having my shins thoroughly kicked when necessary. But this is a case where the government feels the country as a whole must go forward together and not favour a particular group.